anonymising your work. Make sure that you don't include your name, university user ID, or other personal identification anywhere within a document that you intend to submit to an anonymous assignment submission point. This extends to a document's file properties or metadata, particularly if you are using an application such as Microsoft Word. The onus is on you to remove any identifying information from your submission before you submit it. If you are unsure of how to fully anonymize your work, access a submission point and click the Anonymizing Your Work Guide link. This will lead you to a guide explaining how you can remove identifying information from PDF documents or when using applications such as Microsoft Word. File size. Regardless of what type of file you have been asked to submit, anonymous assignment submission points will only accept files of less than 30 megabytes in size. If you attach a file that breaches the file size limit, you will be unable to submit it. File type. Though anonymous assignment submission points will accept any file type, most departments will limit them to accepting only a few very specific file varieties. If a limitation has been set, the submission point itself will indicate what types of file are accepted, both at the point of access and within the submission form itself. Be sure that you read all the information provided to you for the completion of assessed work. Ensure that you submit a document that meets all the necessary requirements, from those that are technical, such as file type, through to those that are assessment specific, such as word count. Check your work. It is absolutely vital that you check any submission you make after you have completed the submission. Accidentally submitting an older version of your work, the wrong file, a temporary file or a corrupt file, for example, will not be accepted as a mitigating or exceptional circumstance. At the post-submission receipt screen, you can immediately check that you submitted the file that you intended to submit and also that it has integrity. It is very strongly advised that you download your work using the link provided and ensure that the downloaded file then opens and looks as expected. You will also be emailed a submission receipt and are again strongly advised to keep this receipt in case of future need. It's worth noting though that the email version of the receipt doesn't provide you with a link to the file you submitted. You can still check the file you submitted at any time, however, by re-entering the submission point itself. A list of all the submissions you have made thus far will appear at the top of the submission form, starting with the most recent. You can download and check submitted files from the provided links, but need to be aware that the last submission you make before the deadline will be the one that is marked. This is the one at the top of the list. The onus is on you to submit a file with integrity and to submit the file you intended to submit. Deadlines. Do not leave it until the last minute to submit your work. Submission deadlines are absolute. If the time of receipt for your submission is stamped at even 1 second past the deadline, your work will be penalized for being late. Note that the time and date of receipt comes from the university's highly accurate servers, not from the time on the device with which you are making the submission. The time is also taken from when your submission has been fully received by the servers, not from the time you start making the submission. It is strongly suggested that you begin your submission at least half an hour before the deadline. Your home internet connection going down won't, for example, be accepted as a mitigating or exceptional circumstance, so be sure to give yourself enough time to adjust for unforeseen circumstances. Bear in mind that uploading from home is likely to be substantially slower than when using a computer that is connected to the university's campus network. If you do intend to work right up until the deadline, consider making an initial submission at least a half hour before the deadline to ensure that you have made one that will not be penalized. As previously noted, you can still submit again closer to the deadline, so be sure to ask yourself whether what you can achieve in that last half hour is worth the risk of being penalized if you have yet to make your first submission. It's also worth observing that starting your submission before the deadline, but with the upload completing after the deadline, will also not be accepted as grounds for a mitigating or exceptional circumstance. If you submit multiple times before the deadline, the last piece of work before the deadline will be marked. If you submit both before and after the deadline, the last piece of work submitted before the deadline will be marked. If you submit only after the deadline, the first piece of work received after the deadline will be marked. Summary tips. The process of submission itself is very easy. All you need to do is attach your file, check a few boxes, and click Submit. Every year, however, we still experience instances of students who have left it just a little too late to make their submission, and consequently miss the deadline by seconds or a few minutes. Similarly, every year we encounter a few students who have submitted the wrong file. Please don't be one of these cases. It's in no one's interest at all for you to be penalized. Double check you have located the correct submission point for the file you are intending to submit. Always give yourself sufficient time to make a submission. As previously noted, we advise starting a submission at least a half hour before the deadline for it. Always check the file you have submitted immediately after submitting it. Download the file from the receipt screen. Make sure this downloaded file opens as expected, and check that it is the version of your work that you intended to submit. Keep the submission receipt that is emailed to you.